Okay, so now we have kind of our homework table on our site. But again, if we wanted to customize it and add in some kind of cool other elements, I'm going to go into images, and I can search Google right here. So I'm just going to type in U.S. history, and we will see what comes up. And if I liked any of these, oh, I like this Join or Die poster, which is fantastic. I'm just going to select it, and again, these images will kind of come in. Now, if I wanted to make this, you know, fit up here on part of my header, I can put the banner back, and I can have the Join or Die image in there. I can also add those images anywhere I want throughout this. So if I wanted a different header here, and we're going to do Civil War. And I'm just going to grab one of these images here. I'll just take this guy. It'll be fine. And so, again, these kind of come down real nicely in here. Now, if I wanted to add a title above this, I can make the image a clickable link by inserting a link. I can also crop the image if I wanted to and zoom in on just a very specific part of it. So I'm just going to move it around. We're just going to get these kind of soldiers right in here. And you'll see that that image is cropped nicely. Now, I need a text box added, so we're going to type in Civil War, since this is going to be the next unit that we're coming up on. Again, I can make this its own page if I wanted to, and we'll have to use probably either the heading or the title option, so it's nice and big, and we'll go ahead and center it. Now, we can also make this area stand out by just emphasizing it using one of the different color pieces, and I'm going to make this one match so you know that this is all part of the Civil War. Now, the other thing that's great is, again, I can embed pretty much any Google app. So if I wanted to embed a YouTube video, but in this case, I'm going to embed a Google My Map. So if I click on My Maps, I'll see a list of all the My Maps that I've created, and there's one that's called Civil War Battles, and if I go ahead and click into it, you'll see the map actually will load directly in here. Now, there's clearly something a little goofy on this map because there shouldn't be a spot in Asia. So we may have to go back in and correct that. But if I wanted to make that a little bit smaller, make this a little bit bigger, I can put those battles right in there. Now, what's great is when you go to that preview again, this map becomes interactive. So students can work through this map without actually having to access it. I can zoom in on these battles, and if I click on this blue one right here, you'll see it's the Battle of Gettysburg. There's a little description that I put in here. There's even a YouTube video link that's all clickable and accessible right through this site. So it's a really great way to start curating some of the content for your course.